Now this is where we are going to start to work with parts. So we're going to assign parts to the various elements in our schematics, for example, to devices, cables, terminals, and so on. But before we do that, we're going to clean the project up further. And that's going to be the central topic of this video. Now the first thing I don't like, I can show you this kind of terminal diagram. So let's change that one and use a nicer one. For example, I like this one, and I'll tell you later on why. You'll see that graphically. Let's click OK, then tilt this. Let's update our reports. This is what you get. This is an example of the X1 terminal strip. This is the one in the cabinet 1. These terminals, so N terminal. Function definition is very important. If you set this up to N terminal, and the next one to PE, you're going to also see that in this diagram, this terminal diagram. So graphical representation, blue one as an N terminal and yellow and green as a PE. So it looks nice to me, and you see the difference between, in this case, phase terminals and the N and PE. Now before we start to assign parts to the next videos, we should decide for which elements in the schematics we do not want to assign a part. For example, we talked about this one in the first course, so external representation. For all the elements in the schematics which are not a scope of supply from our side, so let's set then this cable to external. You're going to lose these parts tab. Okay. Do the same for the connections. Then from these terminals, external, no parts. Let's see on the other pages if there's also some other elements where we could assign external. Is everything okay? These, it's okay, it's for my cabinet 2, it's our scope of supply. These are not, these are already set to external. It's okay. You can see the cyan. We're gonna do the same for the terminals. That's our control, higher level control system. So it's not our scope of supply, scope of delivery. External. Let's go further. Also these terminals from the cabinet 57. Further. Okay, that's it. Now the second thing, for example, these motors here, the black box, this general device, they are the central topic of the mechanical engineering department. So the mechanical engineering department is gonna write about those in their project, in their part of the project. So for us, let's say we're going to say that this is just a general part. Okay, now let's do that first for the motors. For the part, we're gonna say it's gonna be a dummy part. We just decided that we don't want to assign a part for this one. Let's do the same for the black box. You can copy this one. For the black box, just want to assign a part. We want to work with parts only within our cabinets and for the cables. Let's say for this one, just as an exercise, so that later on in the tutorial, in the course, when we start to work in the panel layout, dummy part, and let's say we want to do the same also for our temperature measurement, also a dummy part. Let's see how this looks now, how this looks like in the bill of material. Already have for the PLC, we'll check that later. These are our dummy parts, so the motors, temperature measurement, black box, and service socket for the PLC programmer in the cabinet 3, in the PLC cabinet. So these are the ones we want to work with, and we want to assign part for them in next videos. That's about it for this one, and I'll see you in next videos.